I'm Doug Pavel, and this is my wife, Carol, back here. And this is Lynn Loveridge, who's from Hill City. She's also another small acreage, Sarah. Rockerville. I'm sorry. What did I say?
Hill City.
It's in the same part of the... from Rockerville. There, she's also another small acreage host farm. The whole intent of this place when we bought it in 2001 is obviously to pay for itself. We wanted it to be self-sustaining. And when you start talking about self-sustaining, it's not organic, though. I mean, and there's a lot of people that seem to make that connection, and that's not necessarily true, of course, and we all know that. But we wanted the farm to be sustainable. In western South Dakota, depending upon where you're at, and Dan can attest to this, Roger can certainly attest to this wherever he's at. It goes anywhere from 10 acres per cow-calf pair to 20 to, you go some parts out there is 40 acres. Because we're on the northern hills here, we get the northern hills effect, we get a little bit more moisture, but we're still not far off of that probably 5 to 10 acres per cow-calf pair. So there's no way that we were going to run enough cattle on here to make it profitable and make it sustainable. We moved up from down by Rapid. We did 400 acres of hay in what is now Somerset, South Dakota. We lived down there before it was developed. And so we had a whole list of horse customers that bought hay. We've been in the hay business for 20 too many years. and we're still in it yet. But we were losing our land down there. It was all on shares. And so we bought this property to get away somewhat away from development, but to keep the horse hay market going and keep our customers. And we bought this in 2001, and a month later the ranch that borders us on two sides sold, and we have 90 houses sitting over the hill here now, but we can't see them, so and they're good neighbors. You know, that's the thing about they're all potential. They're potential small acreages is what they are. In fact, our first seminar, we had a couple of the neighbors come over, asked a lot of questions about trees and lawn and not necessarily ag, but it was all part of the big picture. And so the thing that we added for livestock, because whenever we do horse hay, you're going to get rained on, we're going to have cow hay. And Carol has worked for 5 years to get me talked into goats. And for 4 years, I went, not only no, but you know. And but then I really began to realize that there's some potential there. And so so we started the boar goats, meat goats. And when it would have been in 2010, I think it was, we went to a small acreage seminar that South Dakota Extension had put on down in Rapid. And Mindy was there, as well as another extension agent at the time by the name of Penny Nestor. And they were talking about different things with small acreages, and that there was a grant opportunity coming up to be for anyone that was interested to be a host farm. And so Carol and I immediately talked about it, and we applied, and we were one of three sites that were selected at that time in 2011, and because our part of it was 2011, 12, and 13, and actually was extended, as you guys probably know, into 2014, and Lynn was one of them, and then the folks up in by Eagle Butte was the third one.